living room, kitchen, utility, or the laundry room, and then out this door to the huge, humongous three-car garage, which is probably hard to tell the size of it here. That's what I was describing, the little workshop area over there. Electric panel for the house. It's nice not to maybe have it in the house. Here's that 220 plug I was telling you about. The man door. Cabinet in the corner. Flycatcher. Fluorescent lights in the end, the middle, both ends in the middle. And that other cabinetry, which almost looks like something in a house because there's hangers in there, but the 50-gallon water heater, the LiftMaster door openers, speakers out here too. Four speakers. These are speakers. This is wired for sound, that's for sure. Anyways, that was that home theater box. I don't know if you saw it over there. There's a box that said home theater. And we're walking through this nice, beautiful kitchen. Man, like, I don't even see the light here. Light. I hear some light, a little. Anyway. No double ovens. Say that was a Samsung. And the other master bedroom, I guess you'd call it. It's about 15 by 15. All these cables coming out this side, but see there, the TV down there. You can tell the TV was on the wall there. A smaller walk-in closet. The pine doors, as I say, they're okay. It's just they're trying to give you a perspective on them. I mean, they're just unfinished. So I guess you could stain them or paint them. Or painting these, though, is a pain, because we had some, and all those knots always come through. And here's, I say, this is kind of it's a nice bath. Got the same granite in here. Same light fixture as the other room. And then this, what I call quite humongous, nice stone walk-in shower. Surprise there isn't two shower heads, because there's ample room in here. Well, I mean, for two people, because here's two shower heads here, but it's for one operator. Here's the empty shampoo container and the used razor, along with soap. Oh, and here's the
drain that's a little above, as you can see, the floor line. I don't know how the water drains out of there, but
yeah, this is 4 minutes. I'll just walk outside here again. We'll take a walk around the house together. Here we go. So, nice overhang. Again, speakers. Two speakers out here. You got a wasp nest in the corner. Likes to listen to music. Your propane tank looks like about a 250 gallon. The trees, it can make this into a nice spot. Here's your gas, entrance of the gas. And again, the sun here, I'll try and shield it. But you know, the 10 acres I know would go around where this pipe is, it has to be. And there is a ditch, but that ditch running through there don't know if that's irrigation. It may just be for runoff, you know, in the winter. As you can see over there where they've kind of paneled it off for animals, I guess. And down at the other end, there's a couple of pipes that come through over there. And probably that other building over there, I'm not sure if that's, I think it's probably inside the property line. But 10 acres to me would go over there, you know, to those trees and around here. Just trying to show, I mean, it's just kind of, you know, dry. A lot of horse apples over here. And the house up there. Another house beyond over there. And then the backyard here.